This was truly the end of an era. The Avengers, the Saint, the Baron, Man in a Suitcase. And then we got Moore and Curtis as the Persuaders. Beautiful locales, great clothing, lots of champagne, smoking pot on the sink, and lots of stunning ladies. This is the Persuaders. In the 1971 Persuaders, Roger Moore and Tony Curtis, one of the most iconic series, it only lasted one season. But originally the concept came from an episode from The Saint where Roger Moore's character teamed up with the Texas oil baron to solve a crime. And then there was meetings and this idea created the Persuaders. It's an interesting concept, is the Persuaders. Two millionaire playboys, Danny Wilde and Lord Bryn Sinclair. And then we get Lawrence Naismith as the judge, who brings them both together and says this is like getting dynamite. I mean, you know, the concepts, they get brought together, both leading these indulgent lives of drinking, sleeping around. I mean, there's a lot of that. I mean, this is the Persuaders and Tony Curtis in his gloves. Now, apparently, according to Roger Moore, Tony Curtis wore the gloves because he was hammered on cannabis all the time. And in an interview, Roger Moore said that he was sloth because they were actually drinking champagne. John Collins were in this. I mean, and I think Susan George, a lot of stunning actresses back in the day. But they drive around the Mediterranean, or around the nice parts of the UK. And they get, sometimes some episodes, they get involved in crimes and end up helping people. But then the judges appear, and is he, like, it's rumoured that he is manipulating it in the background. I mean, there's a lot going on here. Also, the funky music to this, the John Barry theme, that just defines this series for what it is. And then, of course, we can't forget the cars, the Aston Martin and the Ferrari. They were, like, just as big as them two. I mean, they had to share the billing as well. I mean, they couldn't have, like, Moore and Curtis. They had to have equal billing. And this is really... Roger Moore has just been Roger Moore to me. He's been 007 all the same. But he's playing this character of Lord Brett Sinclair, who's like, brought up as an aristocrat. Whereas Tony Curtis's character's in it. He came up on the streets of New York and became a self-made millionaire, but both have no purpose until this judge brings them together. And every week there's a different crime, normally a murder, but it's the reactions to this stuff, and some of the villains are insane. But this is a treat, is this series. It's got that feel to it. Now, I used to watch this with my family every week. It was big viewing in our house. It was on ITV, you know. Now, in the concept of this series, when they were looking for an American actor, ITV we'd like an American actor. Glenn Ford and Rock Hudson originally were up for it. But then they found out Tony Curtis were available, which sort of made it rather interesting. I don't know if it had worked with Rock Hudson or Glenn Ford. You know, it would have been interesting to find. I could see Rock Hudson, but he's too, like, I don't know. Curtis brought this wackiness to the role. And I can't see Rock Hudson playing that part, nor Glenn Ford. But there is chemistry. Now, did they get on set? There's all kinds of rumours. Joan Collins said in her autobiography, there were issues. But that's because Curtis was smashed out at the time, and Moore were like, just being Moore. You know, I like Roger Moore. He's an amazing person, such a gentleman. But this works. Like you said, it's the perfect mixture. You know, and the sets, I have got a thing about these sets. They used to build back in the 70s and 60s. I think, like, the British did the best sets in these TV series. So I bought the special edition on Blu-ray from Network, and I have to say it's exemplary, just for the extras and the documentaries. And the back history of this series, you know. So I do recommend you getting the Blu-ray version of this. I mean, it's so cleaned up. You know, I watched it on a 4K TV, and it just looked crystal clear, and it's like it's new, you know. And that's why, like, I just love the British series from the 60s and the 70s. You're not going to get this today, you know. And the humour in this is just wacky, you know, the humour. You remember the Avengers, you get them insane stories with that crazy humour. You've got this in this, but it's not as far out as the Avengers. You know, I mean, the first episode when they meet up, it's like who's got the biggest pair of balls, you know, racing each other and all this. And it's overhammed. It's so overhammed. And Maul and Curtis get into a punch-up and wreck this hotel bar. They get arrested. They've got 90 days. Or they help this judge get this, like, mafia boss, you know. And that's where it all starts, and they become really good friends. The Persuaders didn't really do, it was made for the American market, more or less, because that's where all the money was. But it didn't do well in America. It sort of took off a bit, but it was massive in Australia, Europe. In Austria, it's got a cult following, and the German dubbing is meant to be hilarious, what they put to it, but it's got a massive following in Germany. And it was a big hit here. Now, you're just not going to get stuff like this anymore. And, you know, I'm watching this again, going on this journey, watching the Blu-ray of this. And I have to say, it's fantastic. You know, so I'm going to say, get the Persuaders. I really do recommend it. I've enjoyed doing this quick review. So please subscribe, give this channel a like. It helps me out. And I will see you on the next video. The Persuaders. What a cool series.